On September 6th, Manik Sarkar, the former Chief Minister of Tripura and the current leader of opposition, was attacked on his way to his constituency at Dhanpur, Soramura subdivision. He was going to participate in a mass deputation program to Kathalia with the prior permission of the administration. For the past 3 years, he has been prevented from entering his own constituency by the BJP. On September 7th, Sushanto Chaudhary, Information and Youth Affairs and Sports Minister, directly instructed BJP supporters to avenge Manik Sarkar's visit to his own constituency. He said, inch by inch, we will retaliate in a democratic way organizationally.
Inchite inchite jawab dewa hobe gonotantrik poddhotite sangothonik poddhotite bondhura.
Joylal Das, BJP Yuva Morcha leader, provoked the BJP supporters. He said, I want to hand over some responsibility to you. Can you do so? After this meeting, wherever you see CPIM people, break their hands, feet and head. These statements were made in the presence of Pratima Bhaumik, Union Minister of State. Following this meeting, violence started simultaneously in 5 districts the same evening. On September 7th, the house of a CPIM supporter was burnt in Kathalia. On September 8th, the party's district office was attacked at Udaipur district in front of scores of police officers and government forces. A BJP cabinet minister, Ranjit Sinha Rai, was found 200 yards from the site of the violence, encouraging their cadre. On the same day, CPIM Sipoi Jala district committee office at Vishalgarh was ransacked and gutted. The services of the fire brigade were withheld for over an hour after the incident. In Agartala, BJP goons can be seen arriving at the West District Committee office of the CPIM. CCTV footage shows them ransacking the office. Simultaneously, the CPIM State Committee office in Agartala was also attacked and burnt. Cars were vandalized and burned as well. Yet again, the fire brigade took over an hour to reach the office. The violence which began on the night of September 7th resulted in large-scale destruction. In just the following 2 days, that September 8th and 9th, 43 CPIM offices were attacked. Some were demolished by bulldozers, some set on fire, and some ransacked and looted. 4 media houses were also attacked. 67 houses and shops were destroyed. This is not surprising considering that right after being elected to power, BJP cadre destroyed a statue of Lenin in South Tripura district. In July this year too, former Chief Minister Manik Sarkar was attacked. Ever since BJP came to power, the state has witnessed many instances of large-scale violence.